Hello to our senior high school learners. I'm Renette Martinez, your oral communication teacher. Welcome to our lesson. Welcome to our class. This is our first time. How are you today? Are you ready to listen to our first topic? What is your feeling right now? Put an emoji in our chat box that symbolizes your feeling right now. Wow, I guess most of you wrote there a happy emoji. Our lesson objectives are the following. I'll give you two lesson objectives. Number one is you're going to identify the functions of communication using socially relevant images and videos. Second is express social interaction and social emotional expression through shared insights. I will show you five videos. Please take time to watch them. What can you say on each video? Please write a word or a phrase or even an emoji or any symbol you want in the comment section below. What do you see in video 1? How about video 2? Video 3? 4 and 5? What do they have in common? All the videos require communication. What are the reasons why do you communicate with others? Is it because someone wants something from someone else? Or is it because someone needs something from another person? People love to talk. I am talking right now. I guess someone out there is also talking. People do not just communicate because they love to talk. Generally, humans communicate for several reasons. These reasons are called the functions of communication. And each function is based on the speaker's purpose for something. How many do you think are the functions of communication? You guess. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You got it right. There are 5 functions of communication. The first one is regulation and control. From the word regulation, it is rule or directive made and maintained by an authority. Since it is regulated, it means there is a limiting or regulating something. It is control when there is the power to influence or affect people's behavior or the course of event. In other words, communication is mainly used by person in authority or representing authority to regulate or direct others under them. There is a need to control or regulate our behavior. Right now, you are listening to me. Your communication is controlled because after this discussion, it is your time to talk. Okay? Can you give some examples? Among the 5 video clips presented, which video best represents this function? Oh, it is video number 5 because it's about the doctor who is instructing her patient about her medication. Other examples of this include parents' instruction to children, friends giving advice, customers making orders, and more. Let's proceed to the second function. It is called social interaction. Communication allows individuals to interact with others. The most familiar and the primary reason why people communicate is, what do you think? Is to produce social interaction. This is because people love to talk with each other. In their daily course of living, we human beings develop and maintain bonds, intimacy, relations, and associations. Social interaction allows humans to be connected. Right now, we are virtually connected. We have this term, virtual hugs. I'm sending you my virtual hugs, dear students. A family becomes close not because they live under the same roof, but because each member interacts with each other. So take time to talk to your loved ones, especially that most of us study at home. Back to the video clips. Which is the best example for social interaction? Video number? Number five, it is about the man and the woman dating or having an intimate time with each other. All right, the third function is motivation. Motivation as a function of communication refers to a person using language to express desires, needs, wants, likes and dislikes, inclinations, choices and aspirations. This is when the speaker's purpose is to persuade another person to change his or her opinion, attitude, or behavior. So when a person is motivated, he or she is in high energy, inspired. Are you motivated today or sad? What's your reason? Perhaps you are in love. Examples of communication used as motivation include expressing one's ambitions, talking about preferences, making petitions, and more. In the video presented, which video number is the best example for motivation? Video number three. Listening to the speeches of honor students during graduation is an act of motivation. Let's proceed to the fourth function, which is information dissemination. Communication can be used for giving and getting information. This function is used when the speaker wants to make others aware of certain data, concepts, and processes, knowledge that may be useful to them. Getting information may come in the form of questions intended for getting details of information or ideas, commands like imperatives, and even through statements. Let's go back to the videos. Which video is best for information dissemination? It is video number one. It is a teacher-student scenario. The teacher is discussing and he is giving information to the learners. The last function is emotional expression. Communication facilitates people's expression of their feelings and emotion. And emotional expression is a manifestation of one's internal emotional state. It is an important signal that conveys a variety of information regarding a person's state of mind and his or her intentions. In general, we are very emotional, especially women, me, most people during quarantine period suffer a lot of emotional stress. Do you agree? Humans always need to express their emotions both verbally or non-verbally. Emotions are a central part of who we are. Generally, the closer the relationship or the tighter the familiar circle you are in, the easier it is for you to communicate how you feel. That's why most young people say, the more you love, the more it hurts. Oh my! Learn to express your feelings to others. Are you in love right now? Show it! Express it! Going back to the videos, which video is the best example for emotional expression? It is video number 4, because the girl maybe is expressing or sharing her problem to her friends. You can see in the video that they are crying. That's an emotional expression. Now I have finished discussing the five functions of communication. Is it easy? Do you have any questions? To recap, how many functions did we discuss? There are five functions of communication. They are the number one, regulation and control, where communication functions to control our behavior. Number two is social interaction, in which the communication allows individuals to interact with others. Number three, motivation, which motivates and encourages people to live better. Number four is information dissemination, where communication functions to convey information. And the last one is emotional expression, where communication facilitates people's expression of their feelings and emotion. Well, I hope you learned something from our lesson. See you on our next activity. Happy learning!